What's going on? I'm Sam, and the injection mold machine is finally working. So I guess it's actually been working for a while. When we got it, it wasn't running. I had to change a couple gauges out. Some wires had broken off during the shipment. Just some minor small stuff. And it was able to work in manual mode, but not semi-automatic or automatic mode. Semi-automatic mode will run one part every time you close the door, and then automatic mode will just keep popping parts out over and over again. So we hired a company, a guy came out, pretty much just one switch was bad. We got that fixed. The ejectors, I thought something was wrong with, but I took care of all that. And then we were able to find this used mold. I put it in and I started trying to run parts. I think this was the very first part I ran. There's a lot of flashing, which means there was way too much material and pressure. So I started adjusting the amount of material until I was able to get something that was semi-passable, but I was still getting this oozing and like shrinkage in this part because it wasn't cooling properly. And I tried to troubleshoot this, but I couldn't quite figure out how. This one didn't have enough cooling at all. You can see it came out super hot. And some of these didn't have enough material. This is the adjustment for the shot size, which is how much plastic is actually going into this barrel. And I thought that since this had some oozing, it had too much material. So I was making these fine adjustments to how much plastic is being shot in, but I wasn't really getting anywhere. So we had someone come out to show me how to use this machine and what I might be doing wrong. I thought there was a lot of pressures that were set incorrectly, but apparently my mindset on how this machine works and how the settings are was completely backwards. Pretty much I was using this to completely fill the plastic. And then once it would shoot the plastic into the mold, I used this switch to turn it off. Apparently it's never supposed to hit this switch. This isn't really what controls how much plastic is in the mold, but it controls how much plastic gets into the barrel. So while I was trying to control everything with these, it was actually supposed to be controlled with the injection forward timer, which is how long it takes the plastic to be injected into the mold. And I had that set super fast how it was, but since the part is so big, it needs more time of that plastic being injected so it could cool down a little bit. And the other adjustment was the injection speed, where again, it was injecting way too fast and he slowed it down. So by adjusting the injection speed, this is just a speed valve like this. And then there's also pressure valves on this machine. There's a lot of hydraulic valves. I didn't really understand what they all did at first, but after talking to him, I know a lot more about how this machine works. So he changed a few of these settings, mostly the mold closed, which keeps the mold closed for longer so it can cool, and then the ejection forward time and the speed. So instead of shooting all the material in quickly, he kind of set it so that it will shoot just the right amount of material into that mold. And where this was one of the best looking parts that I was able to make, he was able to get these parts looking like this. So way better. These parts don't actually do anything. They just were a test mold that we were able to get before I start making my molds. So this is really cool. These actually look really good. I was very impressed with how quickly he was able to set this up. This machine is from the 70s and super basic. There's very few controls here. You got the temperatures. There's three settings for the nozzle and then two zones on the barrel. There's a screw in here where plastic is brought down into here, and then a hydraulic cylinder that kind of pushes the plastic out. There's this cylinder that just moves the whole barrel assembly to and from the mold. Right now you can see there's a gap so the plastic won't actually inject into the mold. There's a lot going on in here, especially with all the mechanical setups for how this mold closes. And then the mold itself's a little complicated. It has the ejector plate here, which will push the parts out. It has alignment pins. There's some fancy stuff in here for the auto degating. This is stuck on just because of how much extra plastic came, but these runners will break off automatically, and then you don't have to worry about breaking these off of the finished part. These PID controllers are pretty cool too. They're like a mechanical switch here with digital readout. I really find these interesting. But it's almost all up to temperature, so I'm gonna turn this thing on and show you what it looks like. Right now, all the controls are on manual. We're gonna have to keep it on manual so that I can fill up the screw, and then I'll be able to switch it to automatic. And once I close that door, it should just start popping out parts. It has a door safety switch, and then we can turn on the hydraulic pump. The hydraulic motor for this is absolutely massive. And of course, it didn't run the first time. I had to troubleshoot a couple things, but it was just one of the switches wasn't tripped. So I just had to move a couple things around and then it was good to go. Okay, so I just had the ejector plate get stuck and I can't get the ejector pins to retract. The ejector itself is retracting, so there's something stuck in here. I need to take it apart and figure that out. So I guess I'm not showing this thing actually running in this video. Literally the first part that I went to run made this ejector plate get stuck. I think I know what happened, but like I said, I'll have to take the mold apart and figure it out. So this video, I guess, actually isn't gonna have any running parts, but I hope you found it interesting anyway. I really love this kind of stuff, and I'm surprised how simple it was. I was expecting him to come and this to be super complicated, walking through all the pressures on every single hydraulic thing, but literally he just, you know, showed me how to change a couple settings and get this part running great. I know it's gonna take a while to figure out like how to fine tune the adjustment this well, because this just comes with experience. Like, this part is amazing looking, but I'm a lot closer to knowing how to use this machine well than I was just a couple days ago. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and I will see you in the next one. Hey, why do you look so guilty? You look like you did something bad, huh? You're so excited. What are you doing? Jackson. Oh, you're so excited. Hi, Jackson. Hi, Griffin. Sit. What? What did you do? Huh? What did you do?